put a couple drops of dish soap in there. Then using some paper towel will help spread everything around. It'll keep your hand, any grease that might be on your hands and whatnot, off the Lexan as well. The soapier the better. You want to make sure that you really rinse it out thoroughly then. Now that it's cleaned off, do not touch the inside of the body with your hands. I know some people who paint, once they've cleaned the body, they'll actually use latex gloves to apply the liquid mask or masking tape or things like that, just to keep any oils or things like that that are on your hands off of the body. Now that we've got the body properly rinsed off and everything, we're going to go ahead and we're going to set it aside to dry. Now, if you do want to go ahead and speed up the drying process, you can use a hair dryer or a heat gun set to low to go ahead and blast the excess water out. Make sure that you get the extra nooks and crannies, like around the shock towers that you have here. On the 12 scale body, there's the little ridges over the front wheels where water can get trapped. You need to get all of that out. So we're going to go ahead now. It's about 40 degrees outside right now. The wind is relatively calm. It's a little bit humid, but not bad. And we're going to go ahead and we're apply the first coat of paint to the 12 scale body. Now we're outside, we're ready to apply our first couple coats of paint. A couple things you need to be attentive of. First of all, is which direction the wind is coming out of. Right now it's pretty calm, but the wind is coming from behind the camera right now, so we're painting with the wind. You can kind of see with my breath going over my shoulder that we're going in the right direction. You want to apply a number of thin coats rather than one or two real thick ones. The paint doesn't look as blotchy that way. It applies a little bit more evenly that way as well. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to get started. Now what I've also done is before we came outside, I took the can of paint and ran it under some warm water. It helps the paint flow a little bit easier that way too. So just real light, easy strokes. You see I'm not blasting the body with paint. And then always, when you're done applying a coat of paint, flip the can upside down, clean your nozzle out. We're gonna go ahead, we're gonna let this sit aside indoors for about 10-15 minutes. We'll come back, apply another coat or two of the blue, peel off the masking tape, and then we'll apply the white. Back in from outside now, and we did apply three coats of blue and three coats of white to make sure that we had complete coverage over the entire body. If you do notice, I have cut out the area for the right rear wheel well. The reason for this is we're about to go ahead and pull off the overspray film that's on the body itself. I've already kind of prepped half the body so you can see what it'll look like with that film off. You see it's got a real nice sheen to it and everything, and I've started to apply some of the pinstriping that we're going to use. Unfortunately, when I did that, I forgot, if we can take a closer look here, this is the overspray film I've pulled off. And you can see my mark that I put on there for the left rear wheel. Even I make mistakes from time to time, so that's something I'll have to mount the body on the chassis, get everything marked up, but now that I've got the right rear done, I can go ahead and pull everything off. What I've done here too, as you can see, is I've started to apply the pinstriping that I'm going to have on there, and if you see, I've got a little bit of overlap on the front end here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use this piece of tape here as my mark to trim the overlap that I have here. And it's very important that you have a sharp hobby knife when you're doing this. I'm going to use that to lift up the end here. And it's still a little bit over, so I'll trim that, come back and trim that in a little bit. And then just like I did for this side, I'm going to use this bottom line to mark what I'm going to trim here. Now that that's scored, I can lift that up with the hobby knife. And like I say, I'll come back and I'll get a little bit closer to that in a little bit. It's now time to go ahead and pull off any window mess that may be on the body itself. A lot of people use their thumbnails and pick at the corner of whatever tape is on the inside of the body. You can actually pick off parts of the paint by doing this. I'll use my hobby knife and just get right under the corner of the tape and try to pull it up little by little and work it free. There we go. And since this was actually masking tape instead of an actual window mask, this one will come off in a couple different pieces. Now you can see on the outside of the canopy here, we still have the black marks from where I marked it with the felt tip pen. Those will be gone in a moment when I pull off the overspray film, but I am going to use some of the red pinstriping to go ahead and kind of dress this area up a little bit, make it stand out a little bit more. Well, now we're going to show you actually how the overspray film itself comes off. It's really pretty slick. Just grab a corner and pull straight up, and just like that, any overspray that may have been on that body is now stuck to here, and you have a nice pristine surface to apply any decals on. So there you have it. We've given you some basic body painting techniques. As you can see here, this wasn't very labor intensive. Didn't take a whole lot of time. I'd say start to finish just to apply the paint, about 5-10 minutes or so. Had to go ahead, just apply the tape itself, wash the body out, and then we were ready to apply the paint. It doesn't take a whole lot to really snazz up. This is really just a three-color car, too, if you think about it, with the blue and the white. If you do have any questions on any of the techniques that you saw here, feel free to email us at editors@horizonrc.com. Take care.